You thought the 80s and 90s were strange? Well, let me introduce you to the 2000s. A decade filled with copycats, knockoffs, and remakes slash reboots. But subtly woven throughout were some of the genre's most creative and unique. So, let's count down the top 10. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and movie lovers of all kind, and welcome back to the channel. As always, I am your host, Brett Murphy, and for today's video, we are going to be counting down the top 10 horror movies of the 2000s. If you didn't already know, I started a brand new series on my channel that is set to run all throughout the entire month of October, wherein each week I will be counting down the top 10 horror movies of another decade. And so far, I have already covered the top 10 horror movies of the 1980s and the top 10 horror movies of the 1990s, so be sure to check those ones out as well. And once again, I will reiterate that these aren't necessarily the top 10 best horror movies of the 2000s. Instead, I approach these videos in the mindset of if I were to introduce 2000s horror to someone for the very first time, which 10 movies would I recommend? The 2000s were certainly a mix and match for the horror genre, where the box office was primarily dominated by copycats, knockoffs, reboots, and remakes. But if you paid close enough attention, you would also notice that woven throughout were some of the genre's most creative and unique to date. So without further ado, let's hop right into things.
Number 10, The Strangers. Certainly far from the most critically acclaimed on this list, The Strangers takes the tale of a simple home invasion and twists it into an unforgettable, sick, and sadistic game of cat and mouse. As the lead young couple, James and Kristen, must fight for their lives against three mask-wearing assailants. The movie falls in line, like many others, with plenty of age-old tropes and can be pretty generic at times, but when it's working its magic, as those in the masks lurk in the shadows just off camera, as they stalk our leads, it's sure to make your skin crawl. The most impactful moment though, the one that struck fear into audiences' hearts and made this movie last in our minds, is when we find out why they were doing what they were. To which the masked foes simply reply, "Because you were home." Meaning there was no ulterior motive. It wasn't robbery, it wasn't revenge, just a simple act of random, senseless torment and violence, making us feel as though it could happen to any one of us. 9. Trick or Treat. The little indie horror that could. Relatively unknown upon its initial release, but over the years, this low-budget flick has blossomed into a cult classic smash. An anthology film with 5 interwoven stories celebrating all the little horrors of the Halloween tradition, with one common link between all of them. Sam, the little burlap sack wearing embodiment of the Halloween spirit. Within this flick, you'll find interesting characters who aren't quite what they seem, buckets full of blood, a few laughs, and everything dark and twisted that makes Halloween, Halloween. 8. Paranormal Activity. The culprit responsible for the found footage boom of the late 2000s. Though not the most original story at its core, it took a new approach that really shook things up. By making it found footage and considering how low budget it was, it gave it an eerily authentic feel, which is exactly why it was so popular. People felt as though they were watching real people actually be haunted, and that sent chills up and down audiences' spines everywhere. Though none of its sequels managed to come close to recapturing the magic of this first, this lightning-in-a-bottle original still holds all of its charm. 7. The Ring. The remake of the 1998 Japanese original, Ringu. It maintains most of what made the original such a hit for Japanese audiences. A cursed videotape, an investigative journalist played this time by the brilliant Naomi Watts, and an incredibly scary evil spirit seeking revenge known as Samara, offering up plenty of scares, shocking moments, and twists and turns to keep you on your toes. Gore Verbinski brought this tale to life for American audiences, and it quickly became a box office smash hit. 6. Final Destination. You can't cheat death. At least, that's what this franchise has taught us over the years. After a teen gets a premonition of his plane crashing upon takeoff for a school trip, him and his friends get kicked off for causing such a ruckus. Of course, the plane does explode, proving his premonition right. They were meant to die there. It was their time. And since they skipped out on it, death is coming for them. One by one, they all begin to get picked off in brutal and unusual fashion. What follows is an oddly fun and exciting, but equally as horrifying and intense ride as you bite your nails in anticipation as you wonder who's gonna get it next. 5. Saw. The spearhead of the torture porn craze that dominated the genre throughout the 2000s. From college buddies to household names, director-writer and writer-star James Wan and Leigh Whannell's first project together. What was initially a low-budget, straight-to-DVD, shot in a mere 18 days film ended up being one of the most profitable horror movies of all time. That launched the incredibly successful careers of Wan and Whannell, and kickstarted one of the most successful and well-known horror franchises out there. The story is simple enough. Two gentlemen wake up in a bathroom with no recollection of who they are and how they got there and find themselves a part of some sinister and twisted game. 4. Let the Right One In. A little and bullied boy finds love and companionship in a young vampire girl. Seems simple, corny even, almost like Twilight maybe. But nope, instead what follows is a raw, graphic, and beautiful tale all combined into one breathtaking package. Director Tomas Alfredson executed this story to perfection, giving us not only one of the best modern vampire movies, but one of the best modern horror movies altogether. A tough watch at times indeed, but I think a necessary one for the genre.
Hold on there for just a quick second. If you're enjoying the video, don't get stuck on that 87% who are currently watching and not subscribed to my channel. Come on, folks, we had that almost all the way down to 80%. Don't go letting it get back up again. If you haven't already, be sure to hit that subscribe button right now in order to find more content just like this. It would be a huge help to me and my channel, and I would greatly appreciate it. And don't forget to ring that little bell icon, that way you can be notified about all of my latest uploads. And now, back to the video.
3. Drag Me to Hell. Sam Raimi's return to the horror genre. After a 9-year absence in order to tackle everybody's favorite webhead with 3 fantastic Spider-Man movies, Raimi finally returned to his roots with this dark and thrilling flick. After a loan officer played by the wonderful Alison Lohman evicts an elderly lady from her home only to soon discover that the elderly lady is in fact a witch, and has now placed a curse on her. A battle for her life begins as she tries to find a way to escape her fate as a dark force hunts her down. And with this, Raimi gifted us a real memorable treat, and audiences everywhere reveled in the director's triumphant return to the genre where he gained his fame. Number 2. The Descent. I think a more appropriate title for this movie would be Claustrophobia, because that is exactly what it instilled in all of its viewers. A year after a horrifying accident that killed both her husband and child, Sarah decides to go on a cave diving expedition with a group of friends in an attempt to ease her troubled mind. What should have been a routine dive turns nightmarish as the group finds themselves lost, trapped, and hunted by a horde of mutant predators. This tense, atmospheric, visceral thriller is jam-packed with hold-your-breath-until-you-pass-out moments, gross-out gore, and genuine fear as these characters traverse this pitch-black cave and airtight spaces. And coming in at number 1 is 28 days / weeks later. Yes, I am once again counting these two as one entry, my video, my rules. George A. Romero forever changed the genre by introducing audiences to the slow-moving, moaning and groaning, flesh-eating undead. And just like Romero, director Danny Boyle also forever altered the genre by introducing the world to his fast, vicious, relentless, and brutal infected. Whether you go for the more horror-centric 28 days or action-centric 28 weeks, you really can't go wrong with either of these films. Be it Rose Byrne, Cillian Murphy, or Jeremy Renner, as you join them on their journey through the apocalypse, you can be damn sure that the way is going to be paved in blood, guts, and plenty to rip and tear into. These movies feel very similar, despite the change in directors. But that's a good thing. They share the same tone, atmosphere, score, and brilliant sense of fear, dread, and storytelling. Easily the best zombie movies ever made, and with that, some of the best horror content ever made.
So that is all for today's video, folks. Be sure to let me know down in the comments if you agree or disagree with my 10 picks to represent the 2000s. And once again, be sure to check back to my channel regularly throughout the month of October for more Halloween-themed content. If you enjoyed that video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. And if you'd like to see more content, consider subscribing to my channel and ringing that little bell icon. That way you can be notified about all of my latest uploads. And as always, stay safe, thank you so much for watching, and that's a wrap. Hey you, yeah you, if you made it this far, just know I appreciate you. And while you're here, consider hitting that subscribe button.